Hello everyone, this is Sam from Keyboard Studio. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make a text portrait in Photoshop. This kind of effect is a combination of word cloud design and face image. To make the word cloud, you can either design it manually to match your design context or use any online text cloud generator for a quicker way.
Alright, to get started, make a new document with 2400 by 3000 pixels at 300 pixels per inch resolution and with RGB color mode. Click create, then add a solid color adjustment layer and give it black. Now you can delete the white background, select on it and press delete on your keyboard. Press and hold alt key while scrolling up your mouse wheel to zoom in. Then go to file, save as, give a name for the background file and save it as a PNG file. Click save and click OK. So we will use this background file later to make the word cloud design. Now drag the photo onto the canvas and click this check mark. We are going to cut out the background from the photo, so deactivate the background layer for a while, activate the quick selection tool, click the select subject button, zoom in the image, and click select and mask. Here we are going to refine the edge of the selection. So select any view mode that makes you can clearer look at the edges. In this demonstration, I choose overlay. Adjust the opacity for a clearer look if you want. Then set the radius amount to around 5. Then make sure the refine edge brush tool is active. Play with your square bracket case if you want to adjust the brush size. Then start brushing around the edges. If you need to subtract some unwanted areas, activate the quick selection tool. Select the subtract icon and brush around the unwanted areas. And to erase the background color leftovers, tick this decontaminate colors checkbox and adjust the amount gauge. Select output to new layer and click OK. So this is after background removal. I have my model image in black and white already. If you need to convert your model image to black and white, press Ctrl+Shift+U+K at the same time. Then activate the free transform tool by pressing Ctrl+T. Press and hold Alt+Shift+K while stretching one of the corners to resize the image and adjust the position as well. Now make sure the top layer is active and click this icon. Select duplicate layer. Give a name as displacement for the layer copy and the document as well. So the copy now is in a new document. You are going to make this new document as a displacement map with PSD file format. Go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, give 3 pixels for the radius amount and click OK. Then save this document into your computer by going to file, save as, and give a name for it as displacement with PSD file format. Now you can close the displacement document. So now we have two additive files we just created earlier. One is a background color file that we will use as a text cloud shape, and the other one is a displacement map file that we will use to form the face loop for the text cloud graphics. Then let's make a list of words related to the context of your design and save it in a text file. Here I have a list of words related to Albert Einstein. Alright. Now it's time to make the text cloud design. There are many free online text cloud generators you can use to make a text cloud design. My favorite one is word.com. So open it on your web browser. Then click create now to open the tool. At the words tab, click import. Copy all of your words. And paste them into the box. And click import words. At this tab, you can adjust the settings for each word, such as the size, color, angle, and font. But in this demonstration, I leave them all in the default settings. You can also adjust the words options such as repeat. This means some words may be repeated if there's still available space on your shape. Size. This means you can select either to maximize all words according to the available space or using the size column. Leave the link option to none and close the dialog box. Click the visualize to preview. Now it's time to add the shape for the text cloud. So open the shape tab, click add image, click open image from your computer and select the background file we created earlier. Set the threshold to 80% and edges to 1. Click OK and click Visualize again to look at the preview. Then open the Fonts tab, choose any font you want for your text cloud design. Here I choose Headline 1. Click the Visualize again to look at the preview. And now open the Layout tab. Here I choose the horizontal vertical design for my text cloud and try to adjust with different density amounts. And click Visualize over and over again until you're happy with the result. I think 20% density with words inside letters is pretty good for me. Then open the Style tab. Here you can make your custom color for your text cloud. Click the default color codes to remove them. And pick any color you want. Here I pick only white and click Add to Palette to include the color code. If you are done, click Close. Then make the background transparent and click Visualize to generate a new unique text cloud design based on your settings you just made. Then download your text cloud with standard PNG. The standard PNG format is a free option and is good enough for me. But if you want the high definition version, you need to pay for it. I think in most of my projects, the standard PNG version is more than enough, so I don't need to pay for it. Alright, select the standard PNG and click OK. You may also want to generate some more unique text cloud designs with different settings for you to compare which one is best for you. If you are done, go to your download folder, cut all the text cloud files you just downloaded, and paste them into your project folder. Alright, now it's time to make the text portrait. So drag the text cloud file of your choice into the canvas. At the option bar, resize the width and height to 33%. And click the check mark to confirm the changes. Move it to the left corner. Do the same for the second text cloud design. The third, and so on. From here, you can compare them and decide which one you are going to use. Here I choose the fourth one because the text cloud design looks more dynamic. So I delete the first three text cloud designs. Now move it to the left corner. Press Ctrl J to duplicate. Move the copy next to it. Press Ctrl J again to duplicate. Move the copy next to it. Now press and hold your Ctrl key and select all of the text cloud layers. Release the Ctrl key and press Ctrl J to duplicate them. Move the duplicates to beneath. Press Ctrl J again to duplicate them and move the duplicates to beneath. Then press and hold your Shift key and click the first text cloud layer. Then click the last text cloud layer to select all of them. Release the Shift key and click this folder icon to group them. Change the group name to Word Cloud Original. Then press Ctrl J to duplicate the group. Right-click the copy and select Convert to Smart Object. Deactivate the Word Cloud Original group for a while. Then click this effects icon and select Drop Shadow. Set the opacity amount to 80%, 34 for the angle, 6 for the distance, 0 for the spread, and 4 for the size. Make sure the blend mode is multiply and with black for the color. Click OK. Then go to Filter, Distort, Displacement. Leave the horizontal and vertical amount as 10 each, with stretch to fit, and repeat edge pixels options. Click OK and double click the displacement file that we created earlier. You can close this FX dropdown, then press and hold your Ctrl key and click the text cloud layer icon to make a selection over its visible pixels only. Deactivate it for a while, then select the model layer. Then click this icon to add a layer mask for the model image along with the text cloud graphics we just selected. Now you can activate the background color layer press Ctrl-Alt-Shift-E to make a raster version of all visible layers and place it to the top. Then select the original text cloud group, press Ctrl-J to duplicate, activate the duplicate, right-click on it, and select Convert to Smart Object. Move it to the very top, and now press and hold your Ctrl key and click the model layer icon to select its visible graphics. Make sure the top world cloud layer is selected. Press and hold your Ctrl key and click this icon to add a reverse layer mask for it. Then reduce the opacity of the top world cloud layer to around 13%. And finally, this is the result. That's how to make a text portrait effect in Photoshop. If you found this tutorial is useful, please like and share this video and hit the subscribe button as well for more future uploads from this channel. And as always, thanks for watching this video and see you!